after the woman suffered a car accident, rescued by a kind uncle. Uncle has another purpose. This issue of MIYR brings the movie 10 Clover Road. Quarrels between couples are common. But this quarrel between Mary and her boyfriend was extremely fierce. Mary even left the ring and key at home to say goodbye to this lost love. The emotional Mary drove the car on the main road. There is a message from the radio in the car at district time. Currently most parts of the world, there is a massive power outage. Mary didn't care too much. It just so happened that her boyfriend called again. Mary wanted to pick it up. If a distracted person accidentally ran into the front, the car and the person led the car down on the road. When Mary wakes up again, she is wearing a close-fitting vest. The clothes on the outside are long gone. What's more terrifying is, her leg is locked by a chain and cannot move. Mary looked around and found herself in a basement. Just when she was thinking about how to escape, Uncle Howard with a full beard walked in slowly. He brought food to Mary. Mary raised her hands with tears in her eyes, hoping that the other party could let her go, and said that her boyfriend will bring someone to rescue. But Howard claimed that no one would come to rescue her. Just after the voice, Howard dropped a key and left. Mary used the key to unlock the mirror cuffs on her feet and made a weapon to attack Howard. Then Mary set a fire in the basement to attract Howard to come. Mary came forward and attacked when Howard opened the door and came in. Helpless and tough, but Howard was subdued on the spot and fell asleep after being injected with tranquilizers. It didn't take long for Mary to wake up from a coma. This time Howard patiently explained to her. The United States is experiencing a horrible biochemical attack. Aliens invade the Earth. The air outside RO Gin contains toxins and going out rashly is a dead end. Mary was still skeptical after hearing Howard's words. Ward hoped that Mary would show some gratitude and then leave. Mary saw Howard didn't close the iron door, so he hung a cane and walked out. On the way I met Jack, who also lives in the refuge. Jack looks more friendly and gentle compared to Howard. Then Howard led Mary to visit the sanctuary. This refuge was built by Howard and Jack. Sufficient food resources with independent air filtration system. Although a good living environment is not as good as a 5-star hotel, but it can also make people live comfortably. But Mary still suspects that she was kidnapped by Howard and tell Jack this doubt. Jack told Mary that he had witnessed the attack. Something horrible did happen outside. Howard did not lie. But Mary is still unbelievable. So she secretly took the key from Howard's waist, ran upstairs and prepared to open the door at this time. A woman with an ulcerated face lay on the door and asked Mary for help. This situation terrified Mary. At this time she realized. It turns out that everything Jack and Howard said is true. After calming down, Howard didn't blame Mary. And frankly that I accidentally ran into Mary while driving. Cause Mary to appear in this refuge. Ward also confessed to Mary and took out a photo exhibition of his daughter Megan. Ray was so ashamed to see the other party so sincere, she really shouldn't doubt people. In the following days Mary, Jack and Howard are three. After a very pleasant time, we have dinner and play together. Until the day the air filtration system fails. Mary picked up her skepticism again. That day Mary got into the narrow ventilation duct to repair the filter system. Who knows after the repair is over. Mary found the word help on the glass window. I also found a bloody ear stud on the ground. Mary thinks it is not easy. After returning to the shelter, Mary told Jack about Megan. Jack claimed that the girl in the photo, it's not Howard's daughter Megan but a high school girl student, has been missing for 2 years now. So why does Howard have pictures of missing girls? It seems that the perverted uncle has really hammered it. At this moment, the idea of escaping came into Mary's mind again. Mary and Jack tried to use materials from the shelter. Escape the shelter by creating protective clothing. Even if the situation outside is severe, it's better than staying with a pervert. But the careful Howard gradually noticed something was wrong. I also called the two together and took out a bucket of extremely corrosive acid work. The expression on the face is not very good. Jack, a man, stepped forward to block the gun for Mary. He claimed that he stole materials for the purpose of making weapons. Who knows how his guns were taken away. Howard shot and crashed to death. Jack was so scared that Mary yelled again and again. Then Howard shaved off his beard, smiled kindly at Mary and said if she wanted, Mary can form a happy family with him. Mary must be unwilling. She still didn't give up the idea of running away. Mary kicked over the acid on the day of escaping from the shelter. Caused Howard accidentally fell and his body was corroded by acid. Taking advantage of this gap, Mary went back to the room and put on protective clothing. Escaped the refuge along the ventilation duct. Howard grabbed her little feet midway and tried to keep her. It was kicked over by Mary. Mary, who successfully escaped the refuge, thought she was saved. Unexpectedly, at this moment, the alien spacecraft arrived. Mary was stunned on the spot. immediately began to run around avoiding alien attacks again and again. Finally, Mary seizes the gap. Made an incendiary bomb with a lighter and a wine bottle. Thrown towards the alien spaceship. The next second the spacecraft exploded in front of Mary and Mary was saved. Mary went back to the car and heard news from the radio. The survivors gathered in Houston to fight the aliens. This time Mary is not going to run away from her and drive to Houston. Ready to fight side by side with the survivors. The absurd world and fragile people keep running. Curled up in a small space like walking corpses. Waiting for the coming of death, enjoying a moment of pleasure. When death comes, it is the beginning of fear of life. The origin and the end are connected together to form a complete closed loop.